Hello students, I am Mr. Sandeep here. In rapid prototyping chapter, we have started our discussion on various processes. So purpose of all the processes, either it will be on liquid or solid or say in powder form, our purpose is to build a 3D model, that is with help of various techniques. Right? So in rapid prototyping techniques, we can make a model or prototype with help of these processes. So here raw material of your process can be choose from your powder form, your liquid form, or you can choose your final product form. That is nothing but solid, liquid and your powder form. Right, so your final product will be in solid form, so you can choose your raw material and classify your various rapid prototyping processes. So in rapid prototyping processes, you can build your final model with help of your various concepts or various techniques. And here there are mainly, as per our discussion, two types of applications. So either you will require a fully functional model or say prototype or say your concept model, right? So either concept model or fully functional prototype. So in application, if after building your product, if this particular product will be used in a direct application, it will be known as a fully functional product. Or if you are using your model just for checking your dimension or say aesthetic or say other requirement of design, it will be known as a concept model, right? So various concept modelers are used. So what do you mean by concept modeler? Concept modeler is nothing but it is a machine or say it is a system which is using for, or say purpose of the system is to build a concept model, right? So here with help of various materials like for example plastic material or say photoplastic material or various material like resin or say various composite materials, if your purpose is just to make a concept model, concept modelers are used, right? So various concept modelers are used. So in this session, we are going to discuss on various machines or say various systems which is used for making the model, that is just for concept model, not a fully functional prototype, right? So this is a concept of this concept modeler, right? So with help of various material like photoplastic or say photocurable liquid or various systems, you can make your concept modeler, right? So here I mentioned the basic or say concept of this modelers, right? So it is also known as the office modelers, right? So it is very inexpensive technique for developing the concept modelers, because it is very important before actual manufacturing or so before actually putting your product into the application, you have to make some small scale or actual scale but different material model for checking all the dimensions, looks and your aesthetic. So in research and development, it is very important to check the concept before choosing or say improving your product. So you have to develop this model with help of this concept modelers, right? So for many reasons you can make this type of concept model with help of different types of machines, right? So here I mentioned the various concept modelers or say rapid prototyping machines that has been developed for this purpose, right? So here I mentioned the thermal inkjet printer, 3D printer, that is also very famous, Genesis Access printer system. After that, Sanders model maker is there, and Object Quadra systems. So these are the basic modelers that has been developed, and our purpose is to make a model with help of different material like plastic or say any other material to check the concept, right? So here I mentioned the first, that is thermal inkjet printer. So as per our discussion, Thermal inkjet printer is used for making a small scale model or say concept model with help of material available. Right, so this technique is based on the thermal principle. So here, as per our discussion, in the 2D printing, what happens, the ink is used. In the same way here, ink can be deposited on the bed, and just by layer, by solidifying your ink material, you can make your whole model. So that's why thermal term is there. Here thermal, it means after cooling or say after this temperature difference, you can solidify your ink and you can make your model, right? So after after jetting your ink on your build platform and after cooling and solidification, your final model will be ready in layer by layer fashion. So that's why this process is known as a thermal inkjet printer. So in the thermal inkjet printer, here your purpose is to make your final model, right? So here generally two types of materials can be used, that is thermoplastic material or say your build material, and as a support you can use your wax, right? So there are generally two types of head is there, or two types of heads are provided. From the one, your build material is fed or say build material is provided, and from another head you can provide your support material, that is essentially your wax, right? So here by XY movement of your both the heads, you can deposit your material, that is support material as well as build material, and after making one layer and after solidification of one layer, you can make another layer by the Z movement of your table or head or both, right? So this is how you can deposit your ink, and you can cooling or say you can cool down and solidify your particular layer, and you can go layer by layer manufacturing, right? So here I mentioned the construction for this type of printers. So here two heads are available separately. In the one head you can provide your build material in form of various say you can say liquid or say in form of solid pellets, and another you can provide your support material, that is a wax. So heating arrangement is required if you are putting your material in form of solid, right? So here by depositing on the bed and XY movement and Z combination, you can build your whole model, right? So in the same way, 3D printer is also very popular. So this is here I mentioned the image for the 3D printer that has been developed initially. So Z Corporations has developed this type of 3D printing machines. So here I mentioned the history for this 3D printer. In 1997, this Z Corporation has developed this 3D printer machine in the initial basis. So here the technique is same. In the rapid prototyping, you can make your model with help of layer by layer fashion, right? So this 3D printer that has been patented by Massachusetts Institute of Technology, that is very popular, known as MIT. So patent has been drafted, or say this machine has been patented by this MIT, and this machine is basically based on this rapid prototyping technique as per our discussion. So here first of all, powder is spread on the bed, and after that you can provide your liquid form of material, that is our build material. So here I mentioned all the steps for this 3D printing machine. So first of all, powder layer is spread on this bed, and after that what happens, when you provide your material, that is a building material, or say you can say the resin material or say binder material, what happens, it will be solidified with the powder, and powder will fuse together, and after that you can again provide your powder layer, and after that you can provide your binder layer with help of certain head, right? So by with help of some extruder or head, you can provide your binder material, and with help of this binder material, you can bind the powder parts at that particular cross section according to your product, and again powder layer is provided, right? So this process is repeated until your whole model cross sections will be developed on the build platform, right? So the loose powder will be removed with help of vacuum after your process once completed. So here powder, loose powder is provided on the bed, and binder will be provided according to your product cross section or according to your layer slicing, right? So this is how 3D printer works based on rapid prototyping technique. So another system is also popular, that is Genesis Access Printer HP system. So here it is also using the rapid prototyping technique, and here polyester material is used for making the layer by layer model, right? So here you can build your layer by layer model with help of this polyester liquid, right? So this is also under category of this RP system, that is rapid prototyping system, right? So here I mentioned all the datas for this particular Genesis Access Printer HP system. So here I'll mention the build volume that can be built up with help of this system. So you can build your product according to your maximum food space or maximum build volume, right? So here I mentioned also the weight and also the input requirement in terms of AC voltage for this printer system, right? So here material is provided in form of wafers, and after with help of some heating element you can melt your material and provide the layer on your build platform, and after cooling and solidification you can go for the next layer, and from top to bottom you can make a whole model with help of this Genesis system, right? So here I mentioned the various points for this system. So here extruder is also used for providing this material, that is available in form of wafers or say pellets, right? So this is how you can build your whole model. So here I mentioned the model maker, that is MM series, right? That is developed by Sanders. So here I mentioned the Sanders model maker. Here I also mentioned the image for the same. So there are mainly three variants as per I mentioned in this slide, that is the original model maker, and also version 2, and also rapid tool maker, that is RTM, right? So purpose of all these concept modelers are similar to develop a model with help of various plastic materials to check the concept, that is concept modeler, right? So here I mentioned all the data for the model maker. I also mentioned the working area for this model maker and also image for the same. Right, so here as per our discussion, here print heads are provided as per our discussion, and here print heads are used for depositing your material, if any, in your construction of your model. Right, so here as per our geometry, here various powders or say solid material is provided, and heating arrangement is also provided. Right, so here generally two types of material feeding systems are used. So first one is a direct feed line from your, or say with help of compressed air, and second one is with help of certain mechanism, right? So here I mentioned both the system, and both the system points are mentioned here, that is under category of model maker, right? So just try to remember, all this system and all these machines are for building a concept model for your rapid prototyping technique. Right, so object quadra system is also used for making your rapid prototyping models. Right, so in all these categories, our purpose is to provide your raw material in form of solid, liquid, or in powder form, provide your extruder or heads, and also in the build platform, you can make your whole model. Right, so after once model is completed, you can remove the extra support material with help of various techniques, right? So dummy supports are or say needs to be provided while building the prototype. So these are the various concept modelers that can be used for rapid prototyping techniques. Thank you all of you.